The Seminole County school tax issue comes to our studios right now for a live debate. Voters will decide this election if their school property taxes will go up. It would be a $1 million increase or $1 for each $1,000 in valuation. For example, if you own a $130,000 home with a $25,000 homestead exemption, your taxes would go up about $130 per year. WESH News' Aixa Diaz is here now with the two people sitting on both sides of this argument. Aixa.
Meredith, Seminole County voters will weigh in on a proposed tax hike next month, and we have both sides of the debate right now. Seminole County residents and former Orlando Magic coach Stan Van Gundy is with Citizens for Preservation of Property Values. He is in favor of the tax hike, and former Seminole County Commissioner Grant Malloy is representing the Citizens for Accountable Schools. He is against the tax. Gentlemen, thanks for joining us today.
Absolutely.
Let's start with you, Stan. Before we talk about the actual tax hike, let's talk about the Seminole County school system. How is the district doing right now?
Outstanding. I mean, we could give you all kinds of stats, but the two things that stand out to me is we're preparing our kids both for higher education. Our graduates in 2012 earned over $45 million in college scholarships, and we're preparing them for careers and vocations, one of the most extensive career and vocational programs in the entire nation. Every high school in our district has a vocational program unique to the school. We have magnet programs in engineering at Lyman High School, in information technology in Crooms, at Crooms, in the health science, health academy at Sanford, Seminole High School, and in the IB program. We're preparing kids to be the workers of tomorrow, okay, and the leaders of tomorrow. We're doing an outstanding job right now.
Grant, how do you see the school system?
I have students in Seminole County Schools, and I've been pleased with it. And by the way, these good schools are occurring without $100 million extra dollars of tax increases right now. I think we have good quality schools. They could always be better. And I think there are a lot of reforms that we could put in place that don't cost more money, that we can take the money we have, use it more efficiently, and have a better quality product than we currently have. But simply throwing $100 million at it, there's no evidence that throwing more money at a school system is going to improve the performance. Orange County has the one mill tax increase. They have the 0.5% sales tax. They have worse test results, and they spend more per student. So their results should be better than Seminole County right now.
So you both agree the school system is doing well, and Seminole County has enjoyed A ratings for several years, more than 10 years. So, Stan, how do you convince voters that the district needs more money when it's doing just fine?
Well, we're at a tipping point right now. We've had very severe cuts. I think most people are surprised to learn that we're 62nd out of 67 counties in the state of Florida in per pupil spending, that 44 of the counties in our state have an additional millage or an additional sales tax for education. So we're in the minority right now. What are the things being affected? Well, we haven't given teachers raises in 5 years. We've cut school supply budgets to where those teachers are having to reach into their pockets to buy supplies for the classrooms. If those kind of things go on, it's very tough to retain high quality teachers and certainly to recruit new ones. Second thing is, we have not kept up in terms of technology. We've been able to defer those things for now and maintain our ratings, but if we continue to go years without keeping up on the technological front, our kids will get a lesser education. And then finally, we've deferred maintenance on our school buildings and our buses and things like that. You can do those things in the short term with less money and keep getting good test results and keep getting good educational results. But in the long term, you can't sustain that way.
So you don't think this school system will keep its A rating if this is not passed?
I do not, no. I don't see how that can be done, quite honestly.
Grant, what do you think? I mean, if this is projected to bring in revenue $100 million in 4 years, why not go for it?
Well, I would disagree with that quality of school would decrease if you don't give it more money. If you look at real spending, inflation adjusted for K through 12 education in the United States of America, it has tripled since 1970. And if you look at the test results, they've remained about the same. Now, two of the school board members voted against this. Diane Bauer has said, the senior member of the school board has said, they will continue to deliver good quality school whether or not this passes. And I think there's a lot of scare tactics coming out, but if you really want to improve school, there are some reforms you can do that don't cost more money. And I think we also have to keep in
such as
how you pay teachers. Stan says they haven't gotten a pay raise in 5 years. That's really not true. They got a bonus this year. They got a bonus last year. In the past, before the recession occurred, they were getting 7-8% a year pay increases. And some teachers really are deserving of it. In fact, some are probably deserving of more. Some are underpaid. But I think some are overpaid. And what happens in public school system is all the teachers, whether you're a good performer or you're a poor performer, you get the same increase. So where's the incentive to do better in your classroom? If we could take the money we have and allocate it on a merit-based system, you can take the same tax dollars you're using and improve the performance by putting market conditions on pay. You know, much like you do in the NBA, you pay the better stars more than the others.
Actually, what has happened, as you know, in the state, Senate Bill 736 has come online. Rick Scott signed it, that we will rate teachers' performance differently based on test scores, and we will pay teachers according to that. So new teachers starting last year coming into the system now will not be paid on seniority, will not have long-term contracts, will be paid in terms of their rating. They can now move up the salary ladder quicker. That's great. The grant loves that. The problem is we are going to take second and third and fourth year teachers and pay them more at a quicker rate. That does cost money.
I'm going to pause you right there. We're going to take a quick break. Come right back. We'll also talk about exactly who's going to bear the brunt of this tax increase if it does happen. Stay with us.